As more and more large enterprises are adopting G Suite to stay productive, key decision points like protection of data, security, etc. has to be taken care of during G Suite migration process. In this video, we will be showing you how technical success can be managed while transferring Google Apps to another account or domain and move your G Suite data successfully. We bring you the solution with Systools Migrator software. While transferring Google Apps to another domain, admin credentials is required to transfer single or multiple Google Apps users to new domain. Now let's check out the main features of the software. The tool provides option to assign priority to users while performing G Suite migration. The software includes specialized error handlers, which auto-detects internet connection loss and resumes migration successfully. Multiple options to perform source and destination user ID mapping is provided by the software. And the software is compatible with all Microsoft Windows versions. Now let's check out the prerequisites before installing the software. Google Console project has to be created, and API access has to be enabled in Google Cloud Console. Make sure to add scopes and validate both source and destination admin account. Destination users should be already created at destination admin account. And if you are using any of the Windows version mentioned here, then please launch the tool as run as administrator. Now let's install the tool and check its working process. The interface comes as a simple, yet an attractive one. You can click Start button below to proceed from here. In the next window, you can see further options to choose. Before proceeding further, let's have a look at some of the prerequisites. You have to add scopes at the domain level. Clicking on the hyperlink provided here will open up a small window showing the step-by-step method of how to add scopes at domain level. Now let's go through the steps in detail. Log into the Google Admin Console by providing the admin credentials. After successful login, you have to select the security option. Then from the next window, select the Advanced Settings option. Here, click on Manage API Client Access to go to the API settings. Then you have to enter the client name in the respective field option. The detailed steps to generate client name is provided later on in this video. And add one or more API scopes in the next field. And hit Authorize button to proceed further. After the settings are saved successfully, a notification message appears. Now let's get back to the software interface, and enter the source admin mail ID credentials here. And hit Connect button. Then a small window appears with a notification that you have to provide service account client ID and P12 file path as well. And for that you have to refer to the service settings section of the software. Within the settings option, you have to choose the setup option. And then further options can be seen on the right. Clicking on steps to create Google Console project will open up a PDF showing the step-by-step method of how to create Google Console project. Now let's check out the steps to create Google Console project. First of all, you have to log into the Google Cloud Console. Enter the correct credentials to log in successfully. After login, from the My First Project drop-down, you have to create a new project. And then select the New Project option. After entering a project name, hit Create button below to generate a new project. And then go to the navigation menu from the left-hand side. And click on the APIs and Services option and select Credentials. And then choose Credentials from the navigation menu and from the Credentials tab, select Create Credentials option. And then select the Service Account Key option from the drop-down list. Now select New Service Account from the drop-down. And provide any desired service account name, and click Select a Role drop-down option. From the drop-down, choose Project option, and then choose Owner option as well. Now choose the P12 radio button from the key type, and click Create button to proceed. And then download the P12 file and save securely on your local system. This is the file, which you need to browse within Systools Migrator software, later on during the migration process. And then select the main service account from the right-hand side of the Credentials tab. After that, select your new service account. And click on the Edit option from Actions column. And under the service account details, click on the Show Domain-Wide Delegation option. Then check the box to enable G Suite Domain-Wide Delegation. Then provide any desired product name for consent screen, and then click on the Save button to save the changes. Then click on View Client ID to see the client ID corresponding to the new service account. Copy this ID, as this is important during the migration process. User need to give this ID as service account ID, while adding scopes, and during the migration process as well. Now let's check out the steps of enabling APIs in Google Cloud Console. Before starting the migration process, you need to enable number of APIs. Here again you have to go to the APIs and Services menu section of the Google Cloud Console, and then select Library option. Then you can make use of the search option to easily find the desired APIs. For example, search for Admin SDK API in the search field, and you can click on the option below and hit Enable button. Similarly, you can choose and enable Google Drive API and also Gmail API, Google Calendar API, and Contacts API as well. Now let's get back and provide the service account client ID in the first field, which was generated while creating Google Console project. And then hit Browse button below to choose the P12 file key obtained during Google Console project creation. After selecting the file, click Open button to proceed. And click Save button below. Now let's get back to the software and hit Connect button. Now a small window appears, and clicking Yes will redirect you to a web browser for authentication. After entering the credentials, click Allow button. A message appears after successful verification, and you can see the source admin mail ID has been successfully authenticated. Now let's select the destination option. Enter destination admin email ID in the respective field option, and hit Connect button. Now a small window appears, and clicking Yes will redirect you to a web browser for authentication. After entering the credentials, click Allow button. A message appears after successful verification. Now you can see the destination admin mail ID is also successfully authenticated. Then click Next button below to proceed further. In the next window, you can see further advanced filter options to choose. You can select or deselect categories, depending on your requirements. And the date filter option below lets you apply filter options, depending on certain date range for mails, calendars, contacts and documents. Let's choose the mails option in our example, and apply date filter options. And below you can see the user groups mapping option to migrate document permissions. And for migrating the user group permission, you need to provide the CSV file containing list of source group IDs and destination group IDs. Clicking on the sample CSV hyperlink will open up a CSV file showing the format. You can make necessary additions in respective source group and destination group field options, and save the CSV file. And then click Browse button below to choose the saved CSV file from the destination location. And then hit Open button. After making the desired additions, Click Next button below to proceed further. Now a small window appears, with source and user mapping options to choose. Selecting Same as Source Email ID option allows you to migrate data into the same ID in the destination. And the Email Format plus Domain Name option allows users to change both email and domain name, or keep the same domain name. This option provides users select desired format for email name such as first name, last name, etc., and can provide domain name as well. And selecting Change Only Domain Name option allows users to change only the domain name, and the user email name will be same in both source and destination. And the Add CSV File option lets user choose a CSV containing all the source and destination addresses. Clicking the sample CSV hyperlink will open up a CSV file showing the format. After entering necessary details, you can click Browse button to add the CSV file. Now after making the desired option, click OK button to proceed. And then click Next button below. In the next window, you can see the software fetching user details. And after successfully fetching the user details, the software will list all the selected users. Our software supports user priority-based migration. You can select desired users to migrate by checking the corresponding checkbox option. After making the necessary options, click Start button below to proceed further. And after the migration process completes successfully, you can see further details here. Clicking on the Save Report button below will save the export report in CSV format. And you can also view in list view or tile view as well. Now let's check out the output files. By logging into your account, you can preview G Suite migration output in detail. Here you can see output mail details, contacts, calendar, and Google Drive output data as well. We are looking forward to hearing from you. Please share your valuable comments and suggestions below. And that's it. Hope you enjoyed the video. Log on to the given product page for more details on purchasing the product. For any query, mail us to support@systoolsgroup.com. Thank you for watching.